Hey there, I'm Brett, and today on Math Hacks, we are learning how to factor by grouping. Before we get started, I just wanted to extend a huge thank you to every single person who has subscribed to the channel so far. Currently, we are a small channel, but we are a strong channel, and we continue to grow every single day. So thank you so much for watching, subscribing, and leaving positive comments. But that's enough sentiment for today, because we have a lot of math to cover. Today's lesson is a continuation of our factoring polynomials series, and if you're just joining us, I'll link to that playlist so that you can catch up. The technique you're going to learn about today is called factor by grouping, and it is a really slick technique. It works exactly like it sounds. We are going to be taking our polynomials, breaking them into groups, and factoring out the GCF of those groups. And at the end, it'll all tie together nicely. I'll show you exactly how this works in a few examples. In this first problem, we are asked to factor the polynomial x cubed plus 3x squared minus x minus 3. And we are using the factor by grouping method. Now, one thing you might notice in problems where you're asked to factor by grouping is that they tend to have four terms. And that's because we are going to take the first two terms and factor out their GCF, and then we are going to do the same with the second set of two terms. We will also factor out their GCF. And the hope is that in the process of doing this, you will get two binomials which are matching, which you can factor out one more time and then get down to a factored form. That's pretty confusing when we say it out loud, but it will make a lot more sense when we actually do the problem. So let's begin by finding the GCF of the first two terms. So here I have x cubed plus 3x squared. Now if you recall, the GCF is the greatest common factor. That means it's the numbers and variables that are common to both of these terms. If you need a refresher on that, I have a great tutorial on factoring out the GCF that I'll link to. So for x cubed and 3x squared, it looks like the common factor is x squared. So I'm going to factor out x squared. Now we want to do the same thing with the second set of two terms. Here I have minus x minus 3. At first glance, it doesn't look like there's much of a greatest common factor here, and if there isn't, you can always factor out a positive 1 as your greatest common factor. Now I want an x plus 3 to be left behind when I factor out the GCF so that it'll match this one. So to do that, I'm going to choose to factor out a minus 1. And what that will do is it will allow this to become x plus 3. If that confuses you, you can just think that if I divided negative x by negative 1, I would get positive x. And if I divided negative 3 by negative 1, I would get positive 3. So here's what I'm talking about with the matching binomials. We have two terms here. This is one term, the x squared times x plus 3, and this is now our second term. This is the minus 1 times x plus 3. And I know their terms because I have this minus sign in between two things that are being multiplied together. So even though there's pluses in here, these are inside parentheses being multiplied with another thing, so they stand as their own terms. So from both of these terms, I have a common factor of x plus 3. So what I'm going to do here, and it looks a little funny at first when you start doing this, is I'm going to factor out the x plus 3. So just like I factored out an x squared from this because it was common to both terms, we are now factoring out an x plus 3 because it is common to both of these terms. So I'm going to go ahead and keep the parentheses and write x plus 3 out front. And now in parentheses, I'm going to write down what's left behind when I divide out this x plus 3. And that's really easy to see because it's just the factors on the front of both of these x plus 3s. So we have x squared minus 1. Now, the last thing to do is to check to make sure that you can't do any other form of factoring. And in this problem, we actually can, because x squared minus 1 is a difference of perfect squares. So I'm going to factor that into x plus 1 times x minus 1. Again, if you need a recap on factoring difference of perfect squares, check out my tutorial on that. In this next problem, we have x cubed minus 2x squared minus 3x plus 6. And once again, I'm going to use the exact same technique. I'm going to look for the GCF of the first two terms and the GCF of the second set of two terms. So between x cubed and negative 2x squared, the common factor is again x squared. So I'm going to pull that out in front. And then in parentheses, I'm going to write down what I have after I divide out the x squared from both of these terms. So I get x minus 2. Now in the second set of terms, I have minus 3x plus 6. So I notice right away that both of these terms are divisible by 3. So I want to factor out a 3. Now the question is, do I factor out a positive 3 or a negative 3? And to decide that, I'm going to look back at the binomial I've found here. And remember, what's left behind in parentheses over here, I want to match, just like we had them matching here. And that's important for the third step when I factor that matching binomial out. So to get an x minus 2, I want to pull out a negative 3. So I'm going to write minus 3 here. Notice that when I do negative 3x divided by negative 3, I get a positive x. And that matches with this binomial. And then when I do 6 divided by negative 3, I get a minus 2, which also matches with our other binomial. Now that I have these matching, that becomes our greatest common factor, and I factor it out. Lastly, I check to make sure that I can't do any further factoring here, and it doesn't look like I can. So that is our final answer. In this third problem, we are given the polynomial y cubed minus 4y minus 3y squared plus 12. So I'm going to take these first two terms and find the GCF. And then I'm going to take the second two terms and find their GCF. So once again, I want to pull out the number that is the greatest common factor of these two terms and choose the sign that makes it match with the first binomial I found over here. So I know that 3 is common to both 3y squared and 12. And to get a positive y squared but a minus 4, I'm going to pull out a negative 3. That will flip-flop those signs so that it matches. Now we have two matching binomials. That is the greatest common factor of these two terms, so I'm going to factor it out. And once again, our last step is to do any last minute factoring that we might see. And once again, like in our first problem, we have a difference of perfect squares here. So I can go ahead and factor y squared minus 4 into y minus 2 times y plus 2. There you go, that is our final answer. In this final problem, we are given a polynomial that has both x and y variables. And although this may look a lot more challenging, it's really going to follow the exact same process. The only difference here is that when we're pulling out the GCFs, we want to keep in mind what's common to the x's and y's as well as the coefficients. So I'm going to begin by looking at the first two terms and pulling out the GCF. So it looks like between 3x cubed y and 5x squared y, x squared y is common to both of those. So I'm going to write x squared y out in front. Inside, I am left with 3 and an x. and plus 5. If you ever get confused or unsure of whether you pulled out the GCF correctly, you can quickly multiply x squared y back through the two terms to make sure that you get the original here. Next, I'm going to look at the last set of two terms. Here I have negative 6xy minus 10y. So I notice that they're both even, and I can pull out a 2. And I also can pull out a y from both of these. So I'm going to pull out 2y. And I'm going to choose to pull out a minus 2y to get rid of these negative signs. That will leave me with 3x and positive 5, which is good because it matches our other binomial here. So our last step is to factor out the 3x plus 5, leaving us with x squared y and minus 2y. Now, before we circle this as our final answer, we're just going to do a quick scan to make sure that I can't factor it any further. And when I do that, I see that in this second binomial, both of these terms have y's in it. So I can pull out a common factor of y. And because that will be multiplied with the 3x plus 5 as well, it's okay to just go ahead and pull it all the way out in front. So I'm going to pull out the y. I'm going to just write it out here in front. And then I have 3x plus 5 will remain the same. And then in this term, I'm just going to divide out the y's. So I have x squared minus 2. And then that is the fully factored form. You may have noticed that at the beginning of this problem, I could have began by pulling out a common factor of y, since there was a y in all four terms. Had I done that, I would just have a y out in front, and I would do all of the factor by grouping work inside the parentheses. I think it's a little bit more confusing to do it that way, so that's why I chose to just do a normal factor by grouping here, and at the very end, pull out that y. Don't forget that there are a ton of algebra tutorials just like this one over on the Math Hacks channel, so head on over there and check it out. Till next time, I'm Brett, and thank you so much for joining me.